Hello there. My name is Greg Sherman, and I am the faculty member assigned to this course, and I'm also the person responsible for designing it and managing it throughout the semester. It's definitely one of my favorite courses to teach, EDET 620, and you will be learning a lot more about why I like to teach this and why it is a very important course for educators to complete throughout the beginning part of this semester. So the purpose of this particular short video is to give you sort of a broad tour of the course website. The course website will be the place that you will be receiving most of the information associated with the course, and it's where you will be working. And this is an asynchronous class, which means that you can do every project assigned to you on your own time. And all the information that's really important to go from my brain into the world, and maybe your world, will be delivered through within the website. This doesn't stop you from making synchronous experiences happen if you want. I have office hours, and I'm available to meet individually anytime throughout the week. You just have to email me or call me with any requests that you might have. But let's get started then taking a good look at what the parts are to the course website. As you could tell, I'm not using D2L to deliver the course. I'm only using D2L at Radford University to manage the grades and to deliver one course exam that is an assessment over some of the important things presented in the course notes. But there aren't that many. So let's take a look at the course website, and then you can dive in on your own and get to know the space on your own terms and get started creating the very first project that I want you to create this week. So let's take a look here. Here we are on the course homepage, and you'll notice one of the most important things about the course homepage is the announcements button that will change every week. And late Sunday night or early Monday morning, I will be posting new announcements for the week. The course starts on a Monday. It's weekly on a Monday. And I will be emailing you information about the course each week. But know that when you go to the course homepage, all you need to do to get started for the week is to click on the week one announcements button. So, progressing across the menu, the syllabus includes the general information about the course, and this is some of the same information I emailed you in a digital copy of the whole course syllabus. But there's some more information about myself here as well. You can download my Vita if you're interested in learning more about my educational background and my research interests today. There's information about grading, but of course that's all in the paper copy. There's also some more detailed information about myself that I present in an Adobe Spark page. And this is a very cool way to communicate dynamically some information. And you will be learning all about this week as you create one of these for yourself. We'll click the back arrow. And the course calendar is listed here, and this may change throughout the semester. It almost always does, and I will email you some information about any changes that happen. The course calendar includes a description of the artifacts, what the assignments are, how many points they're worth, and when they're due. So that is information that you will be able to review on your own. And again, there is a paper copy, if you print it, it's paper, but there is a copy of this chart in the course syllabus. But again, it may change throughout the semester, so I'll encourage you to come back to this page, which will always be accessible from the syllabus page. And I also have some information about graduate student success and what it means to be a graduate student versus an undergraduate student in some important areas. So that's some important information that you can review on your own. As I mentioned before, each week we'll add a new link to this page under weekly announcements. Right now we have only the first week one posted, and you will notice only the week one projects are posted right now. That will change as we progress into the semester. I will be adding kind of multiple week projects accessible for anybody who wants to perhaps work ahead, but we're not going to be at that place during the first half of the semester. The projects tab includes five distinct areas, and you'll learn more about this as you go through the course. The first week are some projects associated with you telling your story to me and the rest of the class, and also you creating your course shell. One thing you're going to learn about in this class early on is that you see this website that I have authored for the class. This is done in a platform called Weebly. It's one of many free, well, I mean, it can be free. In this case, it is because I'm a teacher, and many, as are many of you, or aspiring to be. But you will be creating a web space for yourself to communicate all your projects, and it will be done in the same tool that I'm using for the course. So whenever I ask you to go to a project or to learn more about a new project for the week, you can access any of the projects, and all the information will be available from these submenus. I have a library of some resources that I will be referencing in the weekly announcements, and you can always go to these. The course notes will be available, and also there's a how-to spot place, and this will be added to throughout the semester whenever I learn about the need to have some general how-tos done in projects. If I have multiple students who don't know how to do something specific that a project asks, I will include some how-tos here. When you click on the student button, here a list of all the students in the class along with your website addresses will be posted. It's blank now because nobody has posted their website, but you will. And so you can always access other students' work in this class by going to their website, which will be linked from this page. And that can be kind of inspiring at times, and it could help you figure out projects. If there are students who might be ahead of you and are doing things that you have a lot of questions about, you might be inspired by their work. So that will always be available here. And finally, if you click on the D2L button up here, that will just take you to the login page for the university's learning management system, which is, well, it used to be called D2L, and now I believe they upgraded to a version of it called Brightspace, but it uses less letters to call it D2L, Desire to Learn, and so I'm still using it now. So that is a look at a quick look at the overall website, and I look forward to working with you this semester. I'm really confident that as you work through all the projects, you will learn a lot about the important ways that technology can be used to improve instructional practice, and you will have an opportunity to express yourself in a variety of ways, both personally and professionally, and you'll have an opportunity to share your work with other students in the class, and also share your work with potential employers if you'll be looking for a job anytime soon. So it can be a very valuable experience, and you can begin this valuable experience by clicking on the Week 1 Announcements button.